My partners, Sam Raimi and Bruce Campbell, we have had the good fortune to be part of a franchise that has lasted now for 40 years. And I think because the goal as the filmmakers, whether we are making a movie with Lee or Ash versus Evil Dead or something with Fetty or when Sam made it, the single goal was to always please the audience. And so what the audience wants from a movie changes over time, but we're always trying to find and work with young filmmakers who can reach out and touch the audience. And so in the horror world, in the sandbox that we put them in, okay, now how are you going to please the audience ultimately? You can torment them, terrify them, make them laugh, do whatever, but we want to make sure that you're serving the audience. And that's what I think at the end of the day makes Evil Dead sticky and last over time. It's interesting when we're working on scripts to go, oh, that's not part of the Evil Dead universe, or no, the Evil Dead wouldn't do that. On this particular movie, we had a little discussion, oh, does the Evil Dead have the ability to pull an earring off? So there was a lot of conversations about what is it that actually is Evil Dead? And I'm probably the most liberal interpreter of it, which is, you open the book, you say the passages, and things happen. So it is a supernatural movie. It's not a slasher movie. It's not a spy movie or anything else. It is a supernatural possession movie, and that's the world that the Evil Dead live in. So it can take place in 1300 AD. It can take your place 500 years in the future, but it's that supernatural possession, and the antagonist always are deadites. So as time went on, I became more interested in working with Lee than saying, oh, let's make another Evil Dead movie. I've been on the set for every single frame of anything to do with the franchise. I'm the only one who's been there in the mud every single day. So in this case, but once I got into it, I realized, even though I was thinking, oh, should I think about retiring or doing something different? I so love being surrounded by creative people and working with a team to solve a problem. And then, so for me, it was a great collaborative experience led by Lee as our general. The whole process of making Evil Dead with Lee was very collaborative. So there was tremendous amounts of conversation about what are these sisters going to be? Who are they going to be? They need to feel grounded in the real world. And I think that that grounding process, I think in the script writing, Lee found a way to do that, to make everything feel like it had a texture and the characters had a place in that universe. We knew after making Ash vs. Evil Dead that any new iteration in the Evil Dead franchise had to advance the franchise and take it out of a cabin in the woods or small town America. So the idea of doing it with two sisters and a family with them, two young females and a young son, that seemed kind of fresh to us and allowed us to play different dynamics which hadn't we hadn't touched on in any other part of the previous iterations. And in this case, I was terrified of kids. We had never had kids in that. Evil Dead Rise is a story of two sisters who have a fractured relationship. One has been on the road and has never been supportive of her sister, who has three young kids and is now a single mother. The sister who works on the road as a guitar technician had not been responsive to her sister's needs in the past, arrives back home, and they have this confrontation. In the meantime, one of the kids, through a natural disaster that happens, discovers the Book of the Dead, and all hell breaks loose. Many years ago, many, many years ago, Sam Raimi, myself, and the Coen brothers had a long discussion about what needed to be in an Evil Dead movie. So there were three rules. The innocent must suffer, the guilty must be punished, and you must taste blood to be a hero.